Now, I hear this year at ThrillerFest, you are the Silver Bullet Award winner. Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm excited.
How does that feel?
Oh, you know, to be recognized by your peers, I think it's always such a great honor. But it's also something that's very important because they helped make it happen. I mean, my diabetes auction is supported by agents, editors, other authors, readers. So it's sort of a joint effort from the whole publishing community. So I kind of feel like, you know, it's our award.
Yeah. And now they present the award to you in a few days on Saturday night. But that's nice, though, this whole time you know you won it, so you're not nervous.
Exactly. It's not like some of the other awards I've been up for. This year I'm up for Arita, and I won't find out if I win it until I get to the conference. But this one, it's already in the bag.
Nice.
Yeah.
Now you have a few books out now. Yep. Why don't you tell us about them?
Okay. Well, I write in several different genres. So I'm writing a small town contemporary series for Mira Books. And I've got 6 books of that series that are out. I just had one come out in April. And I'll have another one come out in November. I also write historicals. So I'll have a historical coming out in October. And I just finished another suspense book. I haven't had some romantic suspense out for a while. So it'll be a kind of returning to this genre. And so we'll go to market with that at the end of August. And we'll see what happens. Should come out in about a year.
Oh, nice. So you keep really busy.
Yeah. Well, I have 5 kids, so you know, I learned to juggle. So.
And I read your bio is so interesting because you didn't have any aspirations initially to be a writer. You taught yourself basically how to write a novel so that you could be home with your kids.
Right. Yeah, I caught my daycare provider drugging my kids with cough syrup to get them to sleep all day.
How did you catch them doing that?
It was in my baby's bottle, and I had 3 of the 5, and when I found it, certain things just clicked. I knew that's why they were so groggy when, or, you know, that's why they were up at night and wanting to play because they weren't getting it when I was home. Wow. So it really freaked me out. I could not trust anybody to watch my kids, so I quit my job to stay home with them, and I needed to do something to help. So I thought, you know, I knew I was a good typist. That was my one asset. So I thought I could start a typing service, or I was looking for other things and I was reading a good book and thought, I wonder if I could do this. So that's when it all started. And it took me about 5 years. It wasn't a quick fix, but
okay.
It took me about 5 years.
It's an amazing story that you turned that around and then you became a successful novelist.
Yeah, well, it's kind of the silver lining too. It was a difficult time, you know, trying to get through that. My husband's business was really struggling and he needed my help financially. I just couldn't do a whole lot with these little kids and not being able to work. But I really loved my book and I would go to bed at night thinking, but my book is good and I'm going to sell my book. And I did eventually sell that book to HarperCollins. And so it was the beginning to, you know, what I have now. So I'm grateful that I had this, but not that happened to my kids.
Right. Yeah. What advice do you have for aspiring novelists?
Just one word, believe. I mean, I think if you believe in yourself, then you will do whatever it takes. You'll write as many drafts as it takes. You'll write as many stories as it takes. You'll market as hard as you have to. You know, you'll do whatever it takes if you really believe in yourself. And I think that's the difference. I didn't know how hard it was to get published when I started.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a blessing that I didn't know that because I just ventured out. I dared, you know, to sort of forge on. And I think that really was a good start for me to have that faith that it's going to work. You know, I'm going to get this published. And so, I think that's the best thing that any writer can have is a belief in themselves.
That's really great. And talking more about that, because one thing I've been hearing a lot at this conference is that all authors get rejections. Even Harry Potter was rejected 20 times before it was picked up by an agent. What advice do you have for dealing with rejection?
Well, fortunately, authors don't have to deal with rejection much anymore. Things have changed. I know that you may be hearing that, and it may be true for traditional publishers, but there's this whole wave of people that are self-publishing. And so nowadays, you can finish a book and publish it. That's not the hard part. The hard part is finding your readers, getting market share. So that becomes the new challenge. It's not necessarily getting your book in published form. There's so many ways to do that now. And before, there really wasn't. You know, if you didn't get with one of the big publishers, then you just had no chance. But with Amazon doing the self-publishing thing and getting books into so many readers' hands, it becomes more about trying to figure out how to grow your market, how to get, you know, those readers and develop into, with each new book, make it bigger.
And What do you have any advice for how to get those readers and connect with them? Do you find social media helpful?
I do. I mean, I think social media is great. I think developing a mailing list is essential. You need to really be able to stay in touch with those people who do support you and just continue to grow that. I'm not an indie author, so I'm not probably as good as they would be at social media. I'm just learning, but I am somewhat of a hybrid author. I have done a little bit of self-publishing, so I have a feel kind of for what they're doing. But by and large, my stuff, you know, has all come out from traditional publishers. But right. I think we all need to use the same tools, and I think social media is really a viable one right now.
Yeah. Well, thanks so much for speaking with us, and congratulations on the award.
Thanks. I'm very excited about it.